coming in from Burmese Ghouls as of now, respecting the power of what Rafflesia brings to the table. Very respectable run.
Yeah, and Sunsparks love their 2-1. Now they are 1 point away from continuing that pattern that the Philippines have been, you know, associating them with the memes from Philippines on point. Sunsparks now, they took down Lunox, but they're going to ban Lunox this time.
Oh yeah, this time they know how he's so strong on it here, but at the same time, the Harry pretty much led off the hook in this game. Burmese Ghouls, they may consider taking the Harry for themselves, but at the same time, they may also open the map here just because Sunspark has the first pick potential.
Yeah,
It's Sunspark.
I think Burmese Ghouls, if you leave the Harry open, Sunsparks can still go for the Kaja first pick. We've seen that being effective in some drafts. They have two choices now, Harif or Kaja. They can even go for the Grok if they feel like it. One of the tanks that has been kind of out of the picture is the Hylos. The team just don't go in that Hylos direction anymore because they found answers to him. Kimmy will be the last man, third time in a row for Burmese Ghouls.
Yeah, Boxiao as well is going to be one of the heroes here to deal with the Hylos that you mentioned as well. But Burmese Ghouls, they are prioritizing other Grok here, and Harif this time also being prioritized from side of Burmese Ghouls. Sunsparks picking the Grok, and then Burmese Ghouls taking the Harif as well as the Kaja up on maybe this time. And Kid001, we've seen him getting double maniacs before, and we might see it this game if Sunsparks needs to be very careful about it, just because they do not have the cool front this game.
Yeah, and Harif, it's going to be Burmese Ghouls' final pick for the series. The road to top 5, Kaja as well, maybe the third time on this hero. Instant lock-in, you see the Harif, you see the Kaja, guess what? Esmeralda comes in for KLVJ, and X-Ball will be picked up for Renzio.
Oh, this is going to be a tough battle here from Burmese Ghouls. They need those burst damage here to deal with the Esmeralda. And fortunately for them, the Hylos is still in the picture. And you can see Sunspark, they're trying to bait Burmese Ghouls to pick the Hylos in towards the Kaja setup for the double tank composition and then just punish it with the next drops. But will they fall for it? Or will they just say, you know what, it's okay, we're going to play the Hylos to deal with Esmeralda. It's going to be fine from Burmese Ghouls. But like you said as well, 10 seconds on the mark here. How are they going to pick this?
And it depends what Burmese Ghouls ban though. If they go for the Hylos to kind of deal with this Esmeralda, Sunspark can easily pick up that Archai to deal with this Hylos instead. So this chicken and egg issue is a push and pull, this tug of war. I wouldn't be surprised if Sunspark decide to go for the Archai or maybe the Lolita. I do prefer the Archai a bit more, but spot on that Hylos pick for Burmese Ghouls.
Yep, at the same time as well, they have to figure out what's the next strategy here. The Marksman division is still available. There's still the carry, they can do fantastic well as Esmeralda. And because the Hylos was picked from side of Burmese Ghouls, they need to be a little bit worried here from Sunspark, because in terms of mobility wise, they cannot outrun on a high loss. But like you said as well, the Archai is just fantastic to deal with this kind of aggression, which unfortunately to say, the Kaja can also do kind of like mini counter this way here.
Oh, yeah.
Just because of the Divine Judgment clashes with the Hurricane Dance, right? So in this case, they need something to protect the Harry, they need something to catch this off guard. But as of now, they will ban the Bruno from side of Burmese Ghouls. So the Marksman division here, there's not a lot of Marksman left.
I'm surprised.
There's still the Granger,
there's still
the Harry.
Yeah. I'm surprised they banned out the Bruno. That's all. That is my first reaction. Like, Sunspark, seriously, you banned out Bruno? I would prefer a fighter ban. I don't know, the Terizla, a Jawhead. But they made their choice, Burmese Ghouls.
Yeah.
They play Claude as well against Evil's Legends. They can fall back to that. But look at Burmese Ghouls, I'm expecting maybe an Archive ban, maybe a Lolita
yeah,
ban.
But as of now, Burmese Ghouls, they need something here. They need more damage to work with. And I feel like the Badang pick is great here, but banning out the Archive is fantastic here. You called that out as well. Burmese Ghouls, they understand the drafts. And I feel like Sunsparks here, they're going to be in for a surprise, because Burmese Ghouls, if they pick the Badang off lane or maybe a Badang fighter role here, they can shred through the Esmeralda's draw. But it's just so many factors here, because Sunspark, they've not revealed the secondary tank as well as their marksman. So there's just so many variables available. They could drop the leader for themselves as well, but seems to me, like you said, the Terizla is going to be focused here from Cyber Burmese Ghouls. It seems to me they need to win this early engagements here. Do not let Esmeralda up, especially on QVJ from Sunspark, to go online into the later stage of the game.
Yeah, and the Terizla pick kind of expected after the Archive ban. So Sunspark now, they've seen what Burmese Ghouls try to do. Burmese Ghouls good with the cover pick on the Panda. Expo was just not in the zone in that last game. He played the Jockey, he played the Terizla. Terizla was fantastic in game one, simply because Sunspark used so much resources to kill Terizla off, but they get very minimal in return. Now Sunspark still have the marks on the carry, the Granger. JP plays a lot of Granger. I wouldn't be surprised if they go back to that particular marksman. But we're going to find out right now. It's going to be the Claude and Lolita for the Philippine teams.
Yeah, this is a great setup as well. The Lolita just synchronized with the Esmeralda very well. Claude, Sunspark's comfort pick here. We saw, I believe it was JP on the Claude before, but it's taking a little bit too long to come online. But hopefully they will be able to drag this out, because right now, Burmese Ghouls, they have the early aggression. And will Sunspark be able to hold on to here? Because it's all hands on QVJ, on the Esmeralda, to carry the team here for the Filipino teams. The Philippine teams.
Yeah, the prodigy of Philippines, but Hayabusa for Burmese Ghouls. We've seen yesterday, RRQ Sin on the Hayabusa was just was literally a shadow. Came in like a shadow, assassinated the rest of Burmese Ghouls, I believe. The rest of Todak, and managing to take those wins away for RRQ. And Burmese Ghouls, they saw that, I like this Hayabusa pick. Good against Cloud. Kind of can access the export and Esmeralda, but the main target will be the marksman for Sunsparks.
Well, based on the drafts here, ladies and gentlemen, this is going to be a tough battle here. Looks like a 50-50 as well, because Sunsparks, they picked their cards here. Esmeralda Lolita combo with the export. We have the Burmese Ghouls here with the Hayabusa to also kind of negate whatever shield is going to be stacked up here from the side of Sunspark. So both of them have equal counters and equal win condition as well in terms of split push or winning the team fights here. But you can see that early aggression wise, Burmese Ghouls definitely have the slight advantage here. Will Sunspark just back off and take a page off Evil's Legends? Let them have the advantage, take a slow peel, punish them after the second turtle when Esmeralda comes up online.
Yeah, I think that is exactly what Sunspark will be looking to do. Burmese Ghouls, they can't play the aggressive style just like what they did in game one. They wanted to do that in game two, but of the Kufra factor, it didn't work out. But for Sunspark, playing slow in this game, 4 to 6 minutes is the pivotal point for the Philippine teams to kind of come online.
It's tough, Husky. I'm telling you, it's tough. This is the last match for this wider of these teams here. Like you said, only one nation will rise forward. Who will it be? Will it be the Myanmar team? Will it be the Philippine team? And in this case here, Sunspark going up against Burmese Ghouls, best of three, game number three here. And Husky, based on the draft here, I'm excited to see who will come on top. But my money is on the Harith. But at the same time, I know Esmeralda can also do it. So, I don't know. I think Sunspark is going to take it. What do you think?
I think a lot of people will agree that Sunspark is going to take this. It's not going to be easy. I expected a 2-1 in favor of Sunspark earlier on. But Burmese Ghouls, they proved that they are here to stay. So, I'm resetting my slate. Last look at the Celestial Palace, at least for this best of three. Burmese Ghouls back on the red side, the side that they want on. Actually, but both games, red side have won. Maybe the color red is what's needed to win the series. And Burmese Ghouls, they are on my side.
All right, all right, all right. Seems to me here is going to be a split vote here coming from the casters panel here, with me, myself, on the blue side and him himself on the red side. Just because of the color doesn't mean we picked a side already,
yeah,
bro.
Yeah, no, we don't. But statistically,
come on.
Statistically, you know, Sunsparks do have a minor advantage over Burmese Ghouls. And if you look at the region itself, Philippines compared to Myanmar, you don't really look too much at Myanmar. They were winning off of this unorthodox picks, but there we go. Final game of this series is either Philippines or Myanmar.
Ladies and gentlemen, Sunspark, Burmese Ghouls, game number three right now. Who's going to come on top here? We have Sunspark on the blue side, and we have Burmese Ghouls on the red side here. Middle side here, a little bit of a trade-off here. Nothing too shabby here or big yet. However, Burmese Ghouls, they're going to be contesting the blue buffs of Sunspark on the bottom side of the jungle.
Yeah, remember we talked about how the little things do add up. Maybe getting killed off for Sunspark's first blood in the second game, this thought this card has effectiveness, and now he's gonna lose that flicker, and Sunspark immediate collapse. They get the stun, first blood for Fuzakin.
Then the revitalized commitment from Sunspark as well to safely disengage. As of now, Burmese Ghouls, they have to punish QBJ and losing maybe right off the bat is not exactly a great plan here, but Sunspark, they capitalize on that kill here. This is gonna buy them a little bit time to work with here, but 3.6k net worth right now, only a 300 deficit here, and Sunspark, they're gonna make sure JP comes up online. But let's take a look at the replay from that fight.
And again, maybe just caught out, it should not have happened. The idea was correct. Want to go for those invade, and now Burmese goes. They want to look for an answer onto Renzio, but Renzio does not have the Firaga armor, thus able to get out. So no, nothing for Burmese goes to get. Fuzakin also survives.
Yep, my oh my. Sunspark as of now, 1-1 here, but you can see mass recalls being popped up here to reset this fight for that turtle buff. Look at this, 8 seconds up on the turtle buff here. QVJ is walking his way through there. They want to contest the turtle buff. The rest of the teams from side Burmese schools are also going to be focused heading towards the northern section of the map, the top side of the map here to deal with that turtle buff. And Panda is nowhere close to the 4 yet. He needs the penalty zone in that next team fight as well. And you can see Sunspark, he's just zoning his way, making sure that he doesn't clear this creep wave in time to go for it, the reinforcements for the turtle buff. But now,
well, they lose Fuzakin. He went in for the check and he will get punished for that. Ace 007, 5 kill VJ. Kill VJ with the falling stomach has to get out. Burmese goes, can they secure this turtle? Yes, they will. Retribution for Harry will make sure that happens. And the glorious pathway right on top of Sunspark. Burmese goes, lays out the big carpet. The Numino Blast actually doesn't connect, doesn't come through for Sunspark. And Burmese goes will punish them. JP the next to go. Lazy Dwayne keeps him alive. The wild charge of Fuzakin. Kid 001 still alive. Zama's one chrono dash. He gets out, but the flicker of Kill VJ. He actually goes to the other side of the wall. Falling stomach goes in. He gets the kill on the Harry, but now four members of Burmese go on top of it. The Grunt comes in, the Grunt gets one though. The Felicia, no more damage from Sunspark. Equal trade, 2 for 2.
Yes, my oh my. Not to mention as well, the Luminum Blast from the Felicia, his was cancelled by Baby's Divine Judgment. If not, things would have went south for Burmese Ghouls, but still, great re-engagement here from Sai Sunspark. They dragged this fight long enough for QVJ to reset his health and come in back with the Falling Star Moon from the side of QVJ.
Yeah, slight unfortunate situation right there that Kill VJ met, he flickered based on the other side of the Guardian Barrier, if not Kid001 would have fallen earlier. But nonetheless, great trade from both teams. They responded accordingly to what each other wants to
do. Nicely done from Rosie's teams here, but like I said as well, the first turtle buff being secured from Zell, it was a pretty all-out fight coming for both these teams, but Burmese Ghouls came up top right now in terms of the economy, just because the Harith can do way much more with compared to Esmeralda with doubt above. So in this case, they need to secure the buffs once again before the next team fight. 8007, higher boost up. We might see a split push here coming from Burmese Ghouls, which is the initial intention that they want to do right now.
And Burmese Ghouls, four members looking for Renzio. Renzio a bit called out by the law and order. They will go for the collapse. Renzio, Firaga armor will be popped instantly. Last standing, cancel the Divine Judgment. Fuzakin is in. Zama's over Kid 001. This guy is fearless, but Kill VJ will punish him. And Burmese go overstep. There go Luminous Blast on top of three. Sunspark now re-engaged. Wants to go for the fight, but Burmese goes managed to disengage from that.
Wow, what a save there from Sunspark. They go for it for the bait. Burmese goes with the saves as well. And Panda going for the swing here. They want to come in this fight. Sunspark, they're going for the swing. But a heel swing to Hayabusa with a shadow kill. They will take the low Lisa. But Sunspark will retaliate and trade one for in the future as well. But blows after blows, this is by far as close as it gets. We're down towards game number 3. We talked about this here. 50-50 for both teams all the way through, and it is happening right here, right now, Husky.
But one of the facts we overlooked in that previous fight, Sunspark, they were fighting 4 versus 5. Claw was left alone in the top lane to farm up to get their first tier turret. So bright side for Sunspark, the Cloud had his free space. JP still clean 0-0-2. Burmese goes, they get that turtle. Sunspark looking for another fight. The Numino Blast only landing on the high low, though. Ice Ice getting engaged on Fuzakin with the power of nature. Not able to do enough damage. They block him back.
Nope, as of now, gonna be taking a chill pill here, because as of now, they're waiting for the right moment here. But Burmese goes, they're looking for that right moment here. But the tier 1 is still up here for both these teams. Both teams do not want to make any sort of mistakes here. Sunspark, you can see, they're taking a chill pill just because Burmese goes have the net worth advantage. And QVJ, he only recently just got his Calamity Reaper. And this is where QVJ is gonna hit like a truck. But Burmese goes, will they fall prey? Fuzakin sees maybe Divine Judgment available. They can't pull it. Forces the wall charge, tries to go for a disengagement here. But maybe will look for a different target here. And it seems to be Burmese Ghouls. They're looking to take the tier 1. How will they do this?
What a wild charge to make sure that maybe doesn't drag him back with the Divine Judgment. Sunspark managing to defend that first tier tower, and that is good news for the Pillar Pillar team. Burmese Ghouls, they have invested resources, but Sunspark still has to be careful because maybe has that ultimate online.
Yes, my oh my, but immortality up on Renzio here. This is where Renzio can get a little bit more aggressive to the next team fight to come here, but it seems to be both teams respecting each other's territory. They're going to be waiting for the next turtle buff before committing this fight. A007 once again trying to go for the pushes here, but it's not going to happen here because for the middle side, they catch up Puts again, they catch up QBJ. So Burmese Ghouls, they're looking to close out this game, and now they have the advantage. They will take two, they will try to get more, and Sunspark, they do not have the Esmeralda in the pool. Renzio trying to go for the defensive. Can they buy enough time for Puts again and QBJ to reset this fight now?
And this is just a mistake from Sunspark. Burmese Ghouls, they were toying around with Sunspark. They saw the Numinum Blast used Wasted to no avail, and they immediately collapsed on Sunspark. Two members in the bottom lane for the Philippine team, Burmese Ghouls. They had four, and they punished Sunspark for that. They will get that third turtle.
Because of this third turtle here as well, the map is pretty much open. Burmese Ghouls is looking to starve out Sunspark. They have to find a way to split push here, but at the same time, we can see A007 up top in Burmese Ghouls here just going in for the split push again. But at the same, as of now, Burmese Ghouls, KZ1, they're setting up shop here to try and pick go for a pickoff. Same goes for Sunspark, which they spotted out the rotation. JP, they see it, and Sunspark, they will disengage here. They know exactly where Burmese Ghouls are right now.
Yeah, and if you are Sunspark in this situation, the best case scenario is that no one dies until the Lord spawns. You need to fight Burmese Ghoul for that objective, and they do have the lineup to do so. We are still waiting for Reflexia to come online. We're still waiting for Fuzaken to be the Grog that he was. And Burmese Ghouls, off of one punish, was able to stall out Sunspark's effectiveness. Now four members will collapse on their top lane.
They're trying to buy time here, but Fuzu can almost get Divine Judgment here, but K001 is there. More charge to disengage, but he's gonna be super fast. He baited out so much spell from Burmese Ghouls, and this is gonna be the opening for Sunspark to take this here too. And also the bottom tower as well. What a play there from Sunspark. Fuzu again with the clutch, but eventually he will fall. Burmese Ghouls, they're overextending as well. Here comes the Selvry from Xbox, but on the middle side.
Great Luminous Blast blazing duet, and Sunspark will now dead. Ice Ice will fall. They're going after Panda as well. Maybe it's here. Divine Judgment. They found the claw. Now Kid's gonna go wild with the higher Pusa. Esmeralda for two though. Kill BJ. Can he save the game? A007 trying to get away. The Kid as well escaping with that Chrono Dash. Kill BJ on his team. They found the Harem. Sunsprox, they saved the game!
Kill BJ is back online. They managed to go for the defense here. A007 fighting against Renzio. He has a Virga armor. Can he go for the bomber? You're gonna find this. Nice side step.
Oh no!
The shadow kill! Kill BJ! But Ace! 007! What a play!
Kill BJ, what in the world was that? You shouldn't be near that X-Ball. Big mistake from Sunsprox. They saved the game, and then might just threw it away. Burmese Ghouls, they have all five members online. They can go for this sword. Sunsprox, they need a miracle, maybe more than that.
Fuzaken trying to buy time once again from the side on Sunspark. A007 on that Hayabusa, level 14. He's gonna press his advantage here. Look at this, he's not afraid. He's gonna go a little bit aggressive. And Sunspark, they have to back up. The Divine Judgment catches on the Rafflesia, and they will take it. Burmese Ghouls, they're doing it. They take the tags. Now, the Lord still up for grabs. Blade Armor finally up available on the high loss here. But like I said, they are going to respect this here. The economy is still 50-50 coming from both sides. Slowly but surely, Sunspark's online timing is going to overcome here. They need to close the gap on this XP curve against this Hayabusa coming from Burmese Ghouls.
Yeah, Sunspark again now. Second time Burmese Ghouls working on that lore, but this time Sunspark, they're not gonna make it in time. Fuzaken is there as a power of nature. Burmese Ghouls, they pull up the lore. Arrival is coming in from Terrisla as well. Fuzaken control his body. Lazy Duet comes in. Can he find a kill? The penalty zone from Panda! And now Lazzetti comes in from Renzio. Godlike for the Hayabusa. And Burmese Ghouls is already two. Kid going crazy. Ace is still alive. Double kill for the Kid. Is it gonna be the fourth from Sunspark down? Triple kill for Harem. Burmese Ghouls find that fight! This might be the fight that Myanmar will push throughout the lower bracket.
My oh my, it all comes down to QBJ to defend against this Lost Butcher. Burmese Ghouls, they are 16-8. They're thinking about closing the game, but now QBJ, he needs to take out Ice, but the high loss though is there. QBJ, he's almost getting burst out, and now Burmese Ghouls, they have the answer towards Esmeralda. Here comes Kid 001, the new kid in the block. Burmese Ghouls, they're thinking about closing this game now.
Kid 001. Might not have the age of KillVJ, but he showed that his youth shine in this game. 6-2-7 on this Harif. Absolutely amazing performance. Sunspark, they messed up once, they messed up twice. Burmese Ghouls with the Lord. They're going to push down that that top lane with that Lord. You look at this replay brought to you by U Mobile.
Yeah, look at this here. The recap. Pulls again was caught off guard. Same goes for the Cloud as well. You can see they were dragged all the way back here from the side of Renzio. And when he tried to disengage, he pretty much couldn't do anything just because of how powerful the Divine Judgment brought into the table. But ladies and gentlemen, here we are going back into the live action because the turtle, the Lord is going to be pushing out the top side. And you can see Sunspark, how will they defend against this here? The split push coming from Burmese Ghouls. Sunspark, they're trying their best to defend against this. What can they do? Shadow Mask being a spender here as well. QBJ, they will focus on the bottom side. Can they kill A007?
Oh,
he
no.
has the impossible, but no, they don't get it. Opens up the map. The top side getting dying here from Burmese Ghouls. How we do this? Luminous Blast.
And Burmese Ghouls, they need to go for the final push, but last insanity from Renzo goes right in. No Luminous Blast. They do find one, but Immortality will give Burmese Ghouls a second life. Sunspark, this is the fight for their lives. They find Renzo. They push Burmese Ghouls back. Booster gets defend the top side, but here comes the Shadow Kill of the higher booster. A007. Look at Kid though, he's insane! Mega kill! Booster Kid knocks him out. Maybe he goes to disengage. Gets out. Now,
yet.
This Harif, a bit isolated. They flicker in. They need the Harif dead.
Kid.
They kill him off. Sunspark, they hold
no.
on. Double kill for kill VJ. Burmese Ghouls, they're not gonna end this right now.
They managed to defend somehow here. Kill VJ says, you may be the new kid in the block, but I'm the real kid. He's gonna try and defend against from side of Sunspark. They lose all the outer inhibitors from the side of Sunspark, but Burmese Ghouls, they're not giving up yet. You can see Sunspark, they want to get more. 8-0-0-7. They can't kill him off yet, though.
Oh,
all the blocks
are
ice. You're in trouble. Will he get finished off? But nope, no follow-up here as Sunspark don't exactly want to overextend their fight now.
Sunsparks have three massive lanes to defend against. Burmese Ghoul will now always have the control on this minion wave. The next Lord will be up in 80 seconds. Sunsparks, they gave out the first Lord. They need the second one to have a chance to stay alive.
Oh no, how will they do this here? But at the former side, Sunspark, they're going for the triple wooden mask strategy here to try and build out the economy. That's the reason why Sunspark is trying to build here. They know they're losing the economy game, and Burmese Ghouls, they're like approximately 8k advantage, and they have to play slow, but
oh,
oh my god. A007 with the cheeky snipes, and here he goes. Sunspark trying to catch up Ice.
They need a fight right now. Ice, the glorious pathway, will be able to get away. Burmese Ghouls, They're not gonna take it fast. They make it slow, they get the disengage, they need the minion wave to come in, and that is where they pull the trigger for that final push.
Yep. They have to take this a little bit slow here. Sunspark, they have to drag this towards overtime. This is where JP is gonna come up online. And Burmese Ghouls, they know this. They have to close this game. They can only go for a couple of pickoffs here. But Sunspark, slowly but surely, they're getting bigger. You can see the aggressions coming from Burmese Ghouls. And Sunspark, they're trying the best to defend against this here. The buff needs to be secured from Sunspark. As Burmese Ghouls, they know this is happening. They're trying to contest this against Sunspark as of now. How will it go down?
Burmese Ghouls, they might want to go for the collapse. AC 007 isolated from the rest of his team.
Lord,
Guardian Barrett does block
soon.
Out Burmese Ghouls, but Lord coming up in as right now. Burmese Ghouls, they're gonna take the fight.
Luminous Blast
on top. Panda gets called out. Sunspark, they go for the collapse. The Fisher is there. Where is the Divine Judgment? Flicker in. Divine Judgment. They foul JP. JP is down. No Claude. He's out of the building. Burmese Ghouls, is this it? Is this the fight that Myanmar will take it to the end?
It's not over because why? Kill BJ. He's super strong. They get the Xbox, but here comes Kill BJ. They take one. They take two. He takes two down and now. Sunspark, what a comeback! And look at it! The Harif will challenge him!
Second
he wants
life.
Those in the middle, but QBJ, he has the bomb, but he goes for the bigger, but eventually, Kid 001 is the one! The clutch for Burmese Ghouls!
This is it! Myanmar, they have done it! Sunspark, The sun will fall! The sun will set! Myanmar, stay alive!